when is enough enough? I'll tell you. I'll tell you when enough is enough. I have this customer that I took on for a friend of mine. He said, hey, I gave this guy your number. He needs help. His last landscape crew didn't do half the trimming, and when they did do the trimming, they scalped a bunch of his trees at the base of them, so it killed the trees and this and that. So I took it on and I mowed it. And I gave him a decent price. It was a little bit lower than what I would want to be on that property, but I took it on anyway to help the guy out, and to, because a friend of mine referred, and he's a friend of his. So, he's an acquaintance of his, we'll put it that way. I don't know how good of friends they are, but anyway. So, I took on the property, and I took care of it all last season, and I've been doing it for, I don't know, month and a half, almost 2 months so far this year, and I plowed his driveway for him all last winter. Well, all last summer, he was always late on his payments. You guys know I invoice at the end of every month. He was late on his payments. I always got paid, but he was always late, and I kept telling him, I'm like, you need to pay these payments on time. You know, it's a system, it's how it works, it's at the bottom of my invoices. It says, the bottom of my invoices say the payment is due within 10 days of the date of this invoice. Otherwise, there will be a $25 late charge. I've never charged him that late charge. On top of that, he over-fertilizes. He has his lawn fertilized like once a month, sometimes more, and the growth is just out of control. Every week, either him or his wife is putting up more and more things that I have to trim around, as far as they plant little trees and get them growing, and then they transplant them to other spots in the yard. Gazebos, raised flower beds, it's just out of control. So, and I never raised his rate all last year when he kept changing all the stuff. Plus, I either had to double cut or bag his lawn every time. Everybody has their own system. The way it works for me is if I have to bag your lawn, it's automatically double. Whatever your weekly rate is, it's automatically double. I've been using that system for a long time, and I never have a problem when it comes to it. People just pay it because I tell them up front. I'm honest with them up front when I take them as a customer. This is the deal. This is how it works, just so that you know. And nobody has a problem with it. If it comes down to where I have to bag, you know, it's fine. The first cut of the season, I usually bag everything and I don't charge extra. It helps me to get the lawn in shape for the season and get it ready to go and make it easier for me the whole season. So they don't get charged for the first one if I have to bag on the first cut. If I have to double cut a lawn, I usually don't charge extra for that. It just depends on the size of the lawn. If it's a huge lawn, then yeah, they're probably going to get an additional charge for me having to double cut it. But that's just how it works. So those things, you know, all added up. I told him starting off this season, I said, listen, I sent him a reminder. I said, listen, you need to pay your invoices on time. They were late all last summer. They were late all winter. So you either need to pay them on time or we need to work something out where you pay in advance each month. And nothing. He didn't reply to me. I should have just dropped his lawn right then and there. But he didn't reply to it. But he has no problem emailing me or contacting me if he wants me to do something, or to hit an extra part or this or that. But when I send him an email, he takes forever to reply, if he replies at all. So I told him a couple weeks ago, I said, listen, you need to cut that fertilizing back or we're going to talk about a different rate for your weekly lawn service. This is what the rate will be. And it took him like 4 days to reply to that email. And he finally replied to it and he said, I'll cut the fertilizing back a little bit. I said, I've never charged you for bagging your lawn. I either have to double cut it or bag it every week. That's how it was last summer because of the massive amounts of growth from the over fertilizing, you know. And I said, I've cut you a good deal. I mow the lawn for a lot less than I want to because all the time it takes me there with the trimming and everything else. I said, you know, we need to come to an agreement here. And he said, you know, I'll cut the fertilizer back. And, you know, that was pretty much the end of it. So that was a couple weeks ago. I mowed it that week. I had to bag it again. I went back. I mowed it last week. I cut it higher than normal, and I still had to bag it again. So about 4 days ago, 5 days ago, what I do is I email him an invoice every month, and then he mails me a check. I offered him the option to have an invoice emailed to him where he can click the link and pay the bill online. He didn't want to do that. So a couple days ago, I emailed him another invoice with the clickable link, and I told him, I said, listen, your bill is overdue. You need to click this link and pay this bill immediately. And he still didn't do it, never replied to me, nothing. So his day is today. I emailed him a final invoice this morning, and I put in that email, this bill is now 18 days overdue. You need to pay this immediately. Here's for the two cuts so far this month. It's also on the invoice. This will be your final invoice from me. I will no longer be able to service your property at this time. Thank you for the work you've provided me, and I hope you have a great summer. And I left it at that. So, I don't know. I'm sure he's going to pay it. He's always, like I said, he's always paid the invoice. It's just always been late. Now, some people will say, well, if he's always paid and you know you'll get your money and just keep it. No, it's a pain. There's all those things on top of it combined that make me not want to do this lawn anymore. So, you know, he, like I said, it's the additional stuff that's added all the time, planted, the more and more weed whacking, the fact that I'm still bagging it every week, and he never wants to pay any more money. And for the amount of time that I spend on that lawn, I can replace it with at least two other lawns and more than double the money I get from that lawn. And that's some things that you guys got to think about. Now, new guys starting off, you don't always have that option. You know, you got to take what you can get. I've been there. I've had to do it. And sometimes you got to do a lot of crap lawns, and you just got to put up with stuff like that because you need the work. But as you guys know, as I've said in other videos, I'm not in that predicament. I don't have to do that. And so that's what allows me to be able to drop that lawn. You know, there just comes a time where enough is enough. And, you know, there's more and more work every time you go. You're not really making any money on that lawn. And they want more and more done for the same amount of money. You know, they don't want to pay any more money. So, you know, you gotta know when to cut your strings. You got to know when enough is enough, and just drop it. So that's the case there. That's my opinion on when enough is enough. Sometimes it's just what you got to do. So it's another day, and we are going to cut some grass.
Let's take a little walk. Well, this is a property I believe I've showed you guys last year, mowing it. I've had it for a few years now, just blowing off some of this driveway here. There is a couple houses that are near this one that I pass, and they do a really good job on the yard, but I always see grass laying all over the driveway after they've left. It's just simple little things like this that make the difference. You would think that it's a no-brainer and you don't really even think about it. You just naturally blow off anywhere that you get grass, but I actually see a lot of companies that leave grass. I see it on sidewalks, I see it on driveways, and it blows my mind. It's just something simple. If you can tell, that nice edge right there along the sidewalk, all done with the FS90. Some stripes there in that front yard with the 52. Yeah, all my edging, look at that, looks pretty good. All my edging done with the FS90. I don't use an actual edger, I don't own one, and I have zero intentions of buying one. I've always edged with a trimmer, and I do just fine. It takes a little getting used to. I've screwed up plenty over the years before I got it down, but this is a garage. This was new at the end of last year, about fall or so. The guy just put it in, which greatly reduced the area I had to mow in the back here. He's been a great customer. I offered to him, actually. I said, we can change the price a little bit, you know, since you did put that in there and reduced a good chunk of the backyard. And he said, no, the price is what it is. He said, I built it. You didn't tell me to build it. So I don't know if you can really tell in the back, but they're putting a big sub-development in back there. This is just a little area here that he added, a little seating area with a fire pit. He put those trees in this year. Got a little bit of grass up in the flower beds there. He hasn't mulched them yet this year. He usually does them himself. So I'll be a little more careful once that happens. A little bit of grass on the neighbor's driveway I got here. Just little things like that, guys, you got to watch for, and blow it off and make sure you do a decent job. That's what makes a difference. This here is a property. I don't believe I filmed this one at all last year. I may have. I'm not really sure. I'm just flat trimming the edges of these sidewalks. You'll see in a minute here, I'll go back and actually put an edge on them with the trimmer that is the FS90s. You guys know that's all I have. I have a couple of these trimmers. And I love them. They're nice and long, which is good for me because I'm 6'1". And when you're tall and you have a short trimmer, you're doing a lot more leaning over all day, and it just destroys your back. So that's why I went with the FS90s. I used to have four of the FS56 RCs, which is technically a homeowner's model. We beat the hell out of those trimmers, and they just kept going and going and going. Phenomenal trimmer. So if you don't have a lot of money, but you're looking for a good trimmer, those things are like $189, $199 all day. And I've used them commercially for a couple years, and they've never stopped working. See there, I'm starting to edge it up now. The reason I go with the string trimmers and edger, you see I move right along. This isn't sped up or nothing. That's just how I go. I thought in the past before about buying an actual edger, and then I thought to myself, you pull the edger out, you edge the sidewalks, then you put it back, then you get the string trimmer out, do all your trimming, or vice versa. What a waste of time, especially if you're a solo guy like me. I could just do it all in one shot with this. I wasn't that good at it in the beginning, and I said, you know what? I'm going to teach myself. I got to get this down. I got to master it. I've had guys tell me before, there's no edge like using an actual edger. You'll never make it look that good. And I've taken pictures, and I've asked people, I'm like, how do you like that? And they said, oh, that looks good. What kind of edger do you use? Well, there you go. So don't give me that crap. If you practice enough and you pay attention to what you're doing, you can make it look just as good. And these boxes right here are technically on the neighbor's lawn. They never weed whack around them, ever. And it always makes my yard here look like crap. So I always trim around them. There's the one tall one, the one furthest to the right there. That's about the only one on my customer's property. But I always trim around them anyway, just to keep it from looking so horrible.
Somebody's got my baby, and now you ain't around me. pretty face, run my fingers through her hair. My love, my life, my shorty, my wife. She left me, I'm tight, cause I knew that it just ain't right. I was thinking about her. At every turn, trying to get my usher on, but I can't let it burn. And I just hope she know that she the only one I yearn for. More and more I miss her, what will I learn? Didn't give her all my love, I guess now I got my payback. Now I'm in the club thinking all about my baby. Hey, she was so easy to love, but wait, I guess that love wasn't enough. I'm going through it every time that I'm alone, and now I'm wishing she'd pick up the phone. But she made the decision that she wanted to move on, cause I was wrong. And I was thinking about her.
Let's do a little mowing with the Scag. I leave the bagging system on this mower in the trailer. As you guys know, I do most of my mowing with the Exmark 52 Vantage Stander. I leave this on the trailer just in case I have a lawn or two I need to bag. I won't have to mess around with a bagger. Sometimes I just throw the accelerator on the stander, but this holds a lot more and it's a lot easier to use sometimes. So this lawn here, she has a lot of mulch in her flower beds that she just had done, and she has a pool that's right on the other side, that hedgerow right there up near the house. So sometimes it's just easier to just bag this thing. So that's it. You're about to find out. I listen to all varieties of music, all different kinds. So enough talking. Let's listen to some music.
I was blown away, what could I say? It all seemed to make sense. You're taking away everything, and I can't deal with that. I try to see the good in life, but good things in life are hard to find. Well, blow it away, can we make this something good? Cannot wait, we're wasting too much time being strong, holding on, can't let it bring us down. My life with you means everything, so I won't give up that easily. I'll blow it away.
Well, I try to do it right this time around. Let's start over.
I just wanted to show you guys this property. I've had this for 4 years. I like how I striped this one. It has a side part and then goes around to the back. And I just go up that little hill right there and around to the back and turn around and come back across the backyard and back down the bottom of the hill. I thought it was pretty neat. It's fun to do like that. And it looks pretty good.